Howdy folks, Seth here. I have a love-hate relationship with YouTube, and I have for quite some time. On one hand, it is a fantastic platform for almost anyone, anywhere to create almost anything they want, and they're willing to host it all for free. I grew up watching YouTube, and I've been a creator on it for almost 4 years. It's been a ton of fun making videos that I'm proud of, sharing them with all of you, building a community of people I feel connected to in an extremely unique way. So then why did I say I have a love-hate relationship instead of just a love relationship? Burnout! It's what every big YouTuber has talked about at least once in their lives. I thought I was immune to it because YouTube isn't my job, I'm not famous enough to feel burnout, but HA! I'm not doing anything special, I'm just playing video games and talking to a microphone while doing it, but for some reason, I am absolutely feeling burnout recently, and I don't know why. I love the games I'm playing. Peglin, Spelunky, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Super Animal Royale, Mario Maker, Multiverses, Tunic, Inscription, holy shit, I played a lot of games! I enjoy playing them, but more so off-camera than on-camera. So what changed? Is it me? Have I just lost touch with what I enjoyed about YouTube in the first place? If that's the case, then maybe what I need to do to fix it is look back at what inspired me to start doing YouTube. Back to where my passion for gaming content originated. Back to... Can you believe this is what brought me here? Minecraft! Released in 2009 and also 2011, this game was all the rage during my formative years. It spread around my elementary school faster than Pink Eye and Cooties combined. I was a pretty early adapter of the game, joining around Beta 1.2, and I was hooked. Not only with the game itself, but more importantly with the culture surrounding it. You see, it was also around this time that my parents got me an iPod Touch, which, looking back, I was way too young to be exposed to the internet, but oh well. In 2001, the YouTube app was a default part of iOS, and it looked like this. God, I miss those days. Being exposed to Minecraft and YouTube at the same time meant that I was rapidly sucked into the fascinating culture of Minecraft content online. Hat Films was the first channel I remember falling in love with. Their Skyland series in particular was overwhelmingly fun. It was just three guys getting together and consistently making a long-running series by just playing a challenge mod of the game. Can you see how that inspiration led to me today? But they weren't the only Minecrafters I grew attached to. Tobuscus made silly songs about Minecraft in addition to his personal playthrough series, Captain Sparkles made a bunch of music parodies based around Minecraft, and my personal favorite of the classic Minecraft YouTubers, SkyDoesMinecraft, who made just an absolute fuck ton of content ranging from mod reviews to playing minigames with his friends to more musical parodies. Why was literally everyone making Minecraft song parodies? These guys were the titans of my childhood, and while I enjoyed a few other channels back then like Smosh, Tomska, The Annoying Orange, and Ed's World, I wasn't anywhere near as obsessed with them as I was with Minecrafters. Which, looking back, big mistake on 12-year-old me's part, huh? Maybe that's what's missing. Maybe I just need to play Minecraft to reinvigorate my passion for video game content on YouTube. I'm bored. Truth be told, while I was obsessed with Minecraft back in the day, I really struggle to enjoy it now. I love some of the online minigames, it's why I'll still leap at every chance to play Minecraft with friends, but single-player vanilla Minecraft just isn't for me anymore. Maybe it wasn't ever for me. After all, the creators I was obsessed with played multiplayer or with mods or various minigames, but I don't know. I just don't think that's the kind of content I want to make today. My interests have changed, and I think that's pretty obvious when you look at who I'm inspired by today. It's interesting looking at who I watch now because it seems my preferences have inverted themselves. I don't watch as many gameplay-focused creators anymore, and while I love the few that I do watch, Minish May, Grand Pooh Bear, Israel Blarg, and Dark Viper AU most notably, I can't say that I truly feel inspired by them like the gameplay-focused creators I used to watch. Instead, I feel far more inspired by, well, completely different channels. Scott the Waz is by far the channel I feel most inspired by these days. Hell, this video is pretty much my attempt to replicate his style, and I doubt I did a good job of hiding that. Granted, this sentence isn't really helping, but whoops, too late, already wrote it in the script. Scott the Waz developed an incredibly creative way to talk about obscure and typically uninteresting video game topics in an interesting, funny, and detailed way. His channel honestly reminds me of my favorite professors in college, as they're able to take topics that very, very few people would normally care about and make them engaging in a way that everyone remembers. I love that, I admire that, and I want to do that for myself. But the problem is that I don't know nearly as much random video game trivia as he does, I don't have any experience writing scripted humor, and I don't have nearly as large of a video game collection as he does, because I sold a lot of my old consoles and video games in order to afford drugs? Perhaps instead of doing what Scott the Waz does, I should do something more in line with one of my other inspirations, Scott Kramer. He also does informative videos where he talks to his audience about things people typically wouldn't care about, but instead of focusing on extremely detailed parts of video game history, Scotty C talks about pretty much anything he thinks of, even if he didn't know much about it before starting the video. He's done videos outlining ridiculous game shows that he'd never seen before, videos about his own nostalgia for PBS shows and weird commercials, videos about challenges he's done or various trends he's noticed on social media, all of which he makes engaging and similarly humorous ways to Scott the Waz. I would love to do something like that, except I have no idea what I would make videos about. One Scott makes content about video games, which he has a long history with and detailed knowledge of, while the other Scott makes content about other forms of media that he might have just recently been exposed to and summarizes them for an audience. The problem is that I don't really get exposed to a lot of media outside of video games. I could try to apply Scott Kramer's recent exposure summary approach to video games, but then my videos would just be less detailed versions of Scott the Woz episode, and I'd feel like I'm stepping on his toes. Alternatively, I could try to make videos with the style and detail Scott the Woz episodes about other forms of media, but if I don't consume a lot of other forms of media, then what the hell am I going to talk about? There is another YouTuber I'm extremely inspired by who could be a good middle ground, who travels the world making extremely detailed videos focused on incredibly niche topics in math, science, history, all sorts of things. And his name is Tom Scott. Why are they all named Scott? Tom Scott videos are incredible. They're engaging, they taught me things about the world I would have never otherwise known. Tom Scott is definitely different from the other Scots I watch, but I love his videos and I would love to do stuff like them. Problem is that pretty much all I have in my wallet are $2 in shoelaces. I can't afford to travel the world. I can't afford it takes weeks studying and fact-checking topics to make sure that my videos are accurate, and I also can't just do videos on whatever is around me because I live in the middle of bumfuck nowhere.
I'm standing out here in the middle of bumfuck nowhere, Kansas, to demonstrate a point that there's nothing interesting in Kansas.
So if I can't copy any of the Scots, what can I do? I guess I could look to other YouTubers for inspiration, but...
Hello all, and welcome back to episode 132 of my Vegas Pro video editing tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to make a meta joke about editing videos while also editing this video.
Nah, this is boring. No speedrun history, how could I do this video? Alright everybody, today I'm going to be showing you how to make one of my favorite meals, an American house salad. What you want to do is get your bowl and fill it up with a leafy green of your choice. For normal house salads, I use spinach, but because this is an American house salad, I'll be using its pre-sliced and flavorless romaine lettuce. Now, what makes this a true American house salad is that we're going to make up for the flavorlessness of the lettuce with some ranch dressing. Maybe it's okay that I don't quite know what I want to do now. I could try to copy the people I'm inspired by and make lesser versions of their videos, but my own skills, experience, interests, and knowledge don't align with what anyone else is doing right now. And I think that's a good thing. Maybe right now it's okay to just make whatever the hell I want to make, drawing inspiration from others when I can, but not forcing myself to replicate one specific person or style. Perhaps by just making whatever I want to make, eventually I'll develop a style that's unique to me. And that's okay. Or maybe I should just change my name to Scott. That seems to be working for all the other creators. I mean, seriously, just think about how many famous creators there are named Scott. Dang, that's a long name. His real name is Scott. There's Joe Scott, Scott Manley, Scott Hanselman, Scott Adkins. Would anyone be mad if I just rebranded ODISeth Scott? We could start a legion of Scots, or a band, the Scott Band. We'd play ska.